And we come to you from one of the truly iconic stadiums in the NFL as you get a look at Lambeau Field here in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Today it's week four and we've got what should be a great one here as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens taking on the Green Bay Packers. Which of these 0-3 teams will visit the win column for the first time? We'll see. We're underway here in week four. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. They'll start on the ground with Strong. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. That's a pickup of 11 and a first down on their first offensive play. Well, there you go. This offense off to a strong start this afternoon.
With a big run and a first down. That's putting what you practice into play. That's excellent execution to get things started.
On first down, right back to Strong. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. The Packers had 0-3 here to begin the campaign. And you hate to have to say it this early in the season, but getting close to must-win time, is it not?
And I totally understand why you expressed it that way, because it's so early in the season, it feels like hyperbole. But I think you are spot on this one. Yes, there's still time to turn things around, but they've got to start to win right now if they have any hopes of trying to make the playoffs.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Not a great start dropping his first target, but let's face it, it won't be his last chance because he'll get opportunities to make up for that one throughout this game.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. He'll drop to throw. To the sideline and incomplete.
That was the first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Officially, that'll be marked down as just a 28-yard punt. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. Baltimore with good starting field position as they come up first and 10 at their 38. They'll start this drive out on the ground. There's the stiff arm. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first.
One of the good things offenses did years ago was they lettered their gaps the same on each side. A gap between guard and center on either side. That's what you want to control when you're trying to run the ball up the middle.
And why is that?
Because typically you don't have a big nose guard in there in an odd front, three-man front, or you have defensive tackles that might line up in the A-gap trying to gain an advantage and get upfield themselves. If you can control that, it gives the back plenty of space to pick and choose where to go.
And there, a great inside run, broke the contact and got some space. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 20-yard line. Jackson. He finds Bateman over the middle. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Here's McGee. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the roll.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Now Jackson. Being chased out left. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. So from outside the red zone now after the sack, a long third and goal. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Eric Stokes. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Charles, that makes now five interceptions and not even five quarters. Remember, he threw four picks last year.
And this turns into a tough situation because a lot of fans, the first thing is, oh, well, we need to change quarterbacks. This is your guy. This is your elite player. You can't just take him out like that. If I'm the coach, I make a little joke and say, you know something, big guy? We're going to change the football. So it's obvious that's the problem. It's not you. Keep firing.
On first and 10, it's Strong. And he'll get down to about the 26-yard line. Give him nine on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and one.
Someone's looking fresh, and this old line is definitely licking their chops. Everyone likes to run block. If you're an offensive lineman, nice early burst, nice gain, too.
Eluding the pressure, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Adafe Owe showing off the pass rush skills. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
And he's caught. And he's going to have the Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They'll look to throw here on first down. And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown. A great play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Packers take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Well, Charles, he's still a young signal caller in this league, second year in the NFL. And I don't know if last year as a rookie, if he would have worked through his progressions like he did on that touchdown pass.
I think you're right about that. We're seeing him grow up right in front of our eyes because when he went to his primary read, he recognized that they were after him as he continued to survey the field, picked up another tuck and delivered a pass exactly where it needed to be. A very mature play for the second-year quarterback.
Good-looking return set up here. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others. Where they think they have an advantage, dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
Jackson. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. Only able to gain a couple there. And third down and six to go.
Defensively, and the key to any screen play is space to work. And there's none to be found there. And they tackle him for just a short gain.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Raven football here as we begin quarter number two. As they've got it with a third down coming up. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. On third down, Jackson. And incomplete here to bring up fourth down as the rookie couldn't haul it in.
Looks like a second empty possession to start the game, and certainly not the way you want to start when you're coming off of a loss last week. Every team talks about starting fast. They're hoping on their next possession, it can be a delayed fast start and get them going.
They'll look to set up his blockers. 39 yards on the punt, just two on the return. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Things progressing to plan so far. Their defense has been solid, and they've got themselves a 7-0 lead after the touchdown the last time they had the ball.
And this is no time to even think about, hey, are we going to milk the clock? Hey, are we just going to do ball control? This is the NFL. 7-0 leads, they don't last very long unless you continue to push the envelope on offense.
From the 25, here's 2nd and 6. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Packer first down.
Not too shabby for his first carry of the game. That's exactly what most teams are looking for. A really good change of pace back.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Give up the middle to Strong. And he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be 2nd down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. This one swung outside the screen. He's across midfield. And finally marked down at the 42-yard line. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. As long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
Trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Back to throw again. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up 3rd down. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the 1st down and move the chains. Again, he'll drop the throw. And that would be incomplete.
What I've seen so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on 3rd down. So far, only about 1 conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection. This is where you kind of start banking those points that come in helpful later on.
Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And this not an easy situation. You're down early in the elements. You're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness, maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go and try and put some pressure on the defense.
And yard there on the keeper, and that's going to leave him with a third down.
Back-to-back runs, that's how that encompassed a maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. To throw is Jackson. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Third catch of this first half for him, and this one is a first down.
This offense is starting to get into rhythm. A nice quick throw there on target, able to pick up another first down.
Play action. Now Jackson. And this is into the hands of Andrews downfield. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. A very solid gain of 27. Jackson on first down. Went incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
And their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
And this is going to be hauled in by the tight end Andrews. The Raven passing game getting in sync. Another first down. Again, Jackson. His throw incomplete.
So it looks like they stopped some fighting them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But this defense gets two more stops. They can keep them out of that area.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. On the carry, McGee. And just good downhill running there as he'll take this to the 15-yard line. So that time they got the left guard with a hold.
And let's face it, in today's ball, you might have that 330-pound guy you're supposed to clear out of there. You might need a little bit of extra help by grabbing the jersey and trying to ride him out.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
This is a helper, not just the coverage, but the entire defense. Is setting the tone in this game.
Ninth play of the drive now on third and a country mile. To throw again is Jackson. Work in the middle of the field and he's got a man complete. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. How about that? They weather the storm of a 3rd and 17 to pick up the first. Here's Jackson to throw. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. That'll give them 8 that time, and they'll be left with 2nd and a couple. They'll run with McGee. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Again, they'll run. This is McGee. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. Yeah. This is McGee. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. A great effort there. His second rushing touchdown on the year. And the Ravens are on the board here in the final minute of the first half. And oh, it's no good. For the second time now in this first half, he's missed an extra point. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Looking into the raindrops, and he muffs it. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. He's on his way. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown. Tucker now to add the point after. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down.
Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit. I liked it when they would fake it from the three-yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead, and oh, there's a fake, and now he's going to get two. That's great. But from the 15, the risk-reward, it's just not there.
So risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Well, you see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippersnappers are trying to do different things in this game, but let's go back to old reliable. Kick the ball through the post.
Get off my lawn.
That's darn right.
About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
So a costly penalty yardage-wise, as that'll move the football down to the spot of the foul.
And what the officials are looking for in these situations, whether you're playing the man or the ball. And if you're playing the man, you get a lot less leeway in terms of what's going to happen at the end of the play. But if you're looking for the football, it's less likely to draw the flag.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Boy, that ball's just hanging up there waiting to be intercepted. That looked doomed from the start, but they took the deep shot anyway, and fortunately, it winds up incomplete.
One more time.
And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. They'll throw now on the final play. And his throw is incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Inside the booth alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. This offense set to begin the third quarter, and Charles, if they had a checklist of things they wanted to accomplish in the first half, certainly at the top of that list would be having the lead, and they've got that here.
That That's always the most important box to check, isn't it? But also, they've had some success in their passing game, so probably an empty box establishing the run. They're on pace for fewer than 100 yards in this one, so now they want to make sure that they get that going so they truly have a control in this ball game and down the stretch being able to be balanced and try to win this ball game.
Here's third and a few inches. Take this all the way down to the Packers 35-yard line. He's able to rip off 32 on that one. It's a first down.
Brandon, they're still in the lead, but momentum's certainly been going the opposite direction. So to me, that's a really important pickup there on third down.
Try and regain some confidence, and you're right. They need to stem the tide a little bit. That certainly helped. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander, and the Packers are going to take over at their 28-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Their defense did its job, forcing the takeaway there to start the half, and now can the offense follow suit?
And you'd better believe that one side of the ball feeds off the work of the other, so they'll have to come out, establish some rhythm, and go down and take the lead.
And this will be a Packers first down as he's got this up to the 40-yard line.
A good run there off right tackle in an old-school NFL football. The right side, the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side.
Oh, the turnover fest continues. Here's another interception. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. Now the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. Three tight ends in the ballgame here on first and 10. After the interception, here's Jackson. And his throw here is incomplete.
I'll give them credit winning that first snap and forcing an incompletion. They're hoping that'll deflate the offense a little bit if they took the field charged up after taking over after a turnover.
Play action. It's Jackson. That's complete. It's Zay Flowers with it. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. On first down, McGee. And a couple of yards as they move it from the 21 to the 19. And now they're in the hurry up. Throwing is Jackson. Incomplete.
That's a nice job defensively disguising their coverage and making it difficult for the quarterback to get on the receiver, and it results in an incomplete pass.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and 8. Now again, right side, McGee. And I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it fourth and inches. And audible here to get a new look. They'll try and run for it. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the 5. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it, but in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. Jackson flushed out right. And he's into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Lamar Jackson, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Ravens are able to widen their advantage. This defense, so many things to worry about in the red zone area, but you'd have to almost think that Lamar Jackson running the football, that might be number one.
It should be number one, and in this portion of the field where things shrink a little bit because the receivers can't run past anyone because they'll run out of real estate, you should have all eyes on Lamar Jackson when the ball is snapped and try and keep him back in the pocket.
Yeah, I don't think that they were surprised he was running it there. They just couldn't stop him, and he ends up in the end zone. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Here's Strong to begin the drive. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Second and nine now. Finding Strong underneath. Give him a gain of five on the completion. And now we've got a third and four.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's going to have the Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Third and four is always a tough call. Maybe a little too long to run for it, but not too long to hit him on the quick slant. And that was well executed. Found the window and zipped it right in there.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And his throw is going to be incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Romeo Doubs is intended receiver, but now it'll be third down. They'll look to throw again. Steps away to his left. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Back to throw here. Inside the 10 to the 7. A big pickup of 38. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. They'll run with Strong. And a little bit of space there takes it inside the 5 to the 3. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. They'll set up to throw. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time is now run out. Third and goal. And keep in mind, very possibly four down territory. They'll try to run with Strong. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. Not at all what they envisioned on third down. 3 yards in the wrong direction.
And you know it pains them to be this close. And you know they're going to want to go for it here. But they absolutely have to kick the field goal, get this back to a one-score game. It's only logical.
And his kick is good. So he's been running back to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal.
I'm not sure that is the kicker you can depend on. Partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. The field goal we just saw has us now at a one-score game, and on this side of the football, things are getting pretty tenuous and stressful.
Blood pressure up a little bit, you think?
I think up a lot of it.
Could you imagine taking the pulse right now? It might be like a jackhammer out there on that side of the ball, but here's what the deal is. I think what we've observed is a team that's been playing not to lose as opposed to playing to win. And they've got to get back to that, and that means opening things up again, being a little more free than what they're trying to get done on offense.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Midfield and into Green Bay territory. 90 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long. If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it, but what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
From the 46, here's second down and two. They'll keep it on the ground. McGee, and he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for first. Jackson now off the bootleg. That's complete. It's Devin Duvernay. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. Call it a gain of three on the play, and it'll be second down. Jackson, options out left, and he is going to lose yardage here. Third down, he's got a lot tougher. That would officially give us a loss of 7. Rolling off the launching pad, he had a linebacker in his face before he had a chance to do much of anything.
Yeah, I think it's big boys up front, that offensive line. They've got to do a little bit better job of protecting him if they're going to continue to run the option like this.
The Ravens on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 14. Here's Jackson. Now one into the hands of Flowers. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 33. Needed 13, they got 14 on third down. Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on first and 10. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Now Jackson. Quick throw here. That's complete. And down to the 20, he'll go before heading out of bounds. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Up the middle they go. McGee. And this will be a gain of 6 when it's all said and done. Down to the 15 from the 21.
I know the game's not over, but there's got to be a sense of satisfaction right now for the guy carrying the football a bunch today. 99 yards, and he has enough time to go into the century mark.
You got to give it to him again, right? Yeah,
there's no doubt about it. You're not worried about losing the other team. You're not worried about getting to the promised land for everyone. When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some boxing, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Tucker's kick is good, but now there is a penalty marker on the field, so let's see what this is about. Trailing in the fourth this close of a game, that's a penalty you just can't afford.
It's an absolute killer, and it's one that drives coaches and teammates insane.
So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal. hands it off out of the gun. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Every yard they gain, getting them better in their field position. And obviously, a field goal makes this a 2-score contest. That's really all they need.
And that means for your play caller, he's not looking to the attack portion of his sheet, right? He's looking for, okay, what do we have that's going to keep us in a good spot? No lost yardage plays. Let's kick a field goal and go up 2 scores. If we score a touchdown, great. But that's not what you're really playing for.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal. He'll try to run this one in. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to perhaps salt this one away. Tucker's kick is good, and that will make this a 9-point lead. So that one, CD, going to make the road back a lot more difficult.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. You know they were praying on the other sideline for a miss because now, as you pointed out, a very difficult road. Down 2 scores, you don't just need a touchdown. You need a chain of events to go your way. You've got to score, somehow get the ball back, and score again. The odds of that happening, not great in your favor.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, 2-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly, then they'll take it from there.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Throwing left sideline there, but it's incomplete.
Now the question is obvious. Do you try to kick the field goal right here knowing that you need 2 scores? I would be thinking about it if I were on that sideline. Get the field goal now, try and get the touchdown later.
He'll try again with the arm here on 2nd down. That is caught at the 7. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. 1st down, and he gets out of bounds.
Now you have to like the play call because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and then completion.
This is caught for a touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Carlson for the extra point. And the lead is down to 2. So there is still time, a little over 50 seconds to go, but this becomes a critical onside kick. Do. Yes, and they're going to win this football game. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though. Now this one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option, and now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
And even though he gets out of bounds to stop the clock, it's not going to matter. That 1st down going to be enough to write a finish to this one.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a 1st down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it.
to him and keep picking up good yardage. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. It doesn't matter whether you watch high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
Oh, second down, McGee. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. So the final seconds tick away.